In the last class, we looked at integer modulo 2, right, with elements 0 and 1, and with the operations addition 2 and multiplication 2, modulo 2, right? Can you see the screen? Everything is fine?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Yes, sir.
So now we can actually extend this and we go for integer modulo 3. So we know that this is a field, right? Because we can play with all the four operations: addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. We can play with all the four operations. So it is a field. Now we go to integer modulo 3. Our reminders will be 0, 1, and 2. And the operations are plus 3 and dot 3. Addition modulo 3 and multiplication modulo 3. Okay, so now let us try to make a table again. Plus 3, 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 0 plus 2 is 2, 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, 1 plus 2 is 3, modulo 3, that will be 0, 2 plus 0 is 2, 2 plus 1 is 3, modulo 3, that will be 0. 2 plus 2 is 4, modulo 3, that will be 1. We can also make a table for multiplication modulo 3. Entries are 0, 1, 2. And so when we multiply, this will be 0. Okay. And then we here also this will be 0. 1 into 1 is 1. 1 into 2 is 2. 2 into 1 is 2. And 2 into 2 is 4, modulo 3, that will be 1. Now, again, we identify the additive entries here, which is 0, 0, 0 here. That means we say that 0 plus 0 is 0, so 0 is self-inverting. And 1 plus 2 is same thing as 2 plus 1 is 0. So that is 1 and 2 are inverses of each other, right? So every element here has an additive inverse. Okay, now if you go to multiplication, I see that there are multiplicative entries appearing here in this table, and so 1 into 1 is 1, right? So 1 is self-invertive, and 2 into 2 is also 1, which is, that means 2 is self-invertive. So every non-zero element has a inverse, because we don't look at for 0, right? So this is the so this is a field. That means this set is a field. So we saw a field with two number of elements, and we saw an example of field with three number of elements. Now we go a little bit further. So now I go for Z4. Next candidate is Z4, integer modulo 4, right? So the entries are 0, 1, 2, and 3, and operations are plus 4 and multiplication of 4, multiplication of. So now let us make a table. Plus 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3. So 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 0 plus 2 is 2, 0 plus 3 is 3, fine. 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, 1 plus 2 is 3, 1 plus 3 is 4. Modulo 4 it is 0. 2 plus 0 is 2. 2 plus 1 is 3. 2 plus 2 is 4. Modulo 4, it is 0. 2 plus 3 is 5. Modulo 4, this is 1. 3 plus 0 is 3. 3 plus 1 is 4. Modulo 4, it is 0. 3 plus 2 is 5. Modulo 4, this is 1. And 3 plus 3 is 6. Modulo 4, this is 2. We have made addition table. Now we can go for multiplication table. With respect to multiplication 4, 0, 1, 2, and 3, 0, 1, 2, and 3. So 0 into 0 is 0, 0, 0, 0. When you multiply, and this side also, this will come 0, 0, 0. 1 into 1 is 1, 1 into 2 is 2, 1 into 3 is 3, 2 into 1 is 2, 2 into 2 is 4, modulo 4 it is 0, 2 into 3 is 2, modulo 4 this is 2, 3 into 1 is 3, 3 into 2 is 5, modulo 4, this is 1. And 3 into 3 is 9, modulo 4 is what? Sorry, this is 2, right?
2.
Yeah, and this is 1. Okay. So now we can circle the additive int is 0, 0, 0, 0. So I want to check that every element has a additive inverse. So 0 plus 0 is 0. So 0 is self-invertive. Fine. Then we have 1 plus 3 is 0. So that is 3 and 1 are inverses of each other. And 2 plus 2 is equal to 0. So 2 is inverse of itself. So that means each element here, 0, 1, 2, 3 has an inverse. Fine. So this is no, there is no problem here. Now you look at multiplicative int here in the multiplication. Yes, us, yes.
Sir, how 1 plus 3 is 0?
1 plus 3 modulo 4. 1 plus 3 is 4. Modulo 4 yes. Operation we are taking. Remember this modulo 4. So whatever sum is coming, I'm dividing it by 4 and looking at the reminders. Okay.
But why are you taking 1 and 3? Is there any pattern?
So I'm saying that. No. So here is, I'm identifying 0. So 0, this side there is 1, this side there is 3. So 1 plus 3 is 0. I have written that only.
Okay,
okay.
So yes.
Similarly, I can say, I mean, this is also equivalent to 3 plus 1. You can see that this also 3 plus 1 is also 0.
Right? Yes, sir.
Got it?
Yes, sir. Got it. Thank you.
Now, okay. Now we go for the multiplication. Now, so 1 into 1 is 1, right? 1 into 1 is 1, and 3 into 3 is 1, right? So there are two only. Now the question is it a field? Can anyone answer?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Why it is not?
No,
why
sir.
It is not a field?
We are not multiplicative inverse of 2.
Yes,
so element should have multiplicative.
Every non-zero element should have multiplicative inverse, and 2 doesn't have any inverse because 2 into 2 is equal to 0 here, right? So inverse of 2 does not exist, you know. We don't know what is inverse of 2 here. So there is a problem. This is not a field. In fact, this is known as ring, another algebraic structure known as ring, which is a generalization of field. Remember field where we can play with all the four operations, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. And in this case, we know that it is a ring. It is not a field. Fine. Now we go to the next case. So you remember I have told you about z2 in the last class. Z3 we look at, it is a field. Z4 is not a field. We go to the next one, z5. Z5 is 0 1 2 3 4. All this is known as modular arithmetic, modular, because we are doing modulo operation every time, and the operations are plus 5 and multiplication of 5. So let me try to make the tables for you. Plus 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. When we add with 0, 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, 3, 4, 1 plus 4 is 5. Modulo 5, this is 0. 2, 3, 4, 2 plus 3 is 5, which is 0. 2 plus 4 is 6. Modulo 5, that is 1. 3, 4, 3 plus 2 is 5, modulo 5, this is 0. 3 plus 3 is 6, modulo 5, that is 2. And 3 plus 4 is 7, modulo 5, that is how much?
Sir, 1. Sir, there should be 1. 3 plus 3 is 6, modulo 5, 1.
Okay, yeah, so this is 1. I do mistakes, yes. And then 4 plus 3 is 7, this should be 2. Good. Then we go to the 4 plus 0 is 4, 4 plus 1 is 5, which is 0, 4 plus 2 is 6, that is 1, right?
1.
4 plus 3 is 7, that is 2, and then 3, correct? Similarly, now we can make a table for multiplication, and multiplication table is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. This will be 0 anyway when we multiply 0 0 0 0 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 2 into 2 is?
4.
4. 1, 3. And when you multiply 3, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 2, 1. I think it's easy for you to calculate these things. Now we again mark additive identity 0 here in each column and row. Now it turns out that it is clear that 0 plus 0 is 0. 1 plus 4 is equal to 0. So 1 and 4 are inverses of each other. And 2 plus 3 is equal to 0. So 2 and 3 are inverses of each other. Correct? So every element has an inverse of itself. Every invert has an inverse. So 0 has is inverse itself. And 1 and 4 are inverses of each other. And 2 and 3 are inverses of each other. So every element has an inverse here. Fine. With respect to multiplication, I identify the multiplicative identity 1. I encircle here. And now I want to check, is it a field or not? So clearly 1 into 1 is 1. Right? So 1 is inverse of itself. 2 into 3 is 1. So 2 and 3 are inverses of each other. And 4 into 4 is 1. So 4 is inverse of itself. So 1 and 4 are inverses of each other. And 2 and 3 are inverses of each other. So every non-zero element has an inverse. So this is a field, right? This is a field. No problem. Now, I would like to ask you a question. What is 1 by 2 here? Can anyone answer 1 by 2?
3.
Because it is a field, we can do all the operations, right? So 1 by 2 means?
Inverse of 2.
Right?
Inverse. 3.
And this is inverse of 2 is 3 here. Right? 3. So this is 3. So it is 1 by 2 is not 0.5, it is 3. Right? Similarly, you can check that what is 2 by 3? 2 by 3 is 2 into inverse of 3. Inverse of 3 is what?
4.
2?
4. Yeah.
2. So this is 4, right? So this is a little bit bizarre, right? So now 1 by 2 is not 0.5, but it is 3. This is a finite field, okay? So things are a little bit different here. Got it? Any question up to this point? Yes.
Sir, for multiplication inverse, we do not check for zero.
Yeah, you see, as I told you, with respect to we don't divide by zero, right? Because in the multiplication table, we check that every non-zero element should have an inverse, okay, in order to make it a field. So every non-zero element here has an inverse except zero, right? So one is inverse of itself. 2 and 3 are inverses of each other and 4 is inverse of itself, right? Because we don't divide by 0, right? In even the real numbers also, we don't divide by 0, right? We say that A is not equal to 0 when we divide, right? So, you observe something interesting. Now, you see that N is equal to 2, it is Z2 is a field. N is equal to 3, it is a field. So, I can ask you this question here now. Zn is a field if and only if what happens? N is, I want some condition. So you can check N is equal to 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and so on. So N is equal to 1. Is there a field? No, right? 2, there is a field, Z2. You saw that Z2 is a field. N is equal to 3. Is it a field? Yes, because you saw that, yes, right? Z3 is a field. Z3 yes. Is a field, right? So, yes, Z3 is a field. Fine. N is equal to 4?
No.
So, actually, this construction is not giving a field. So, whether we don't know whether there exists a field or not. So, I will tell you what to do here. N is equal to 5, yes, there is a field. N is equal to 6, you know, we don't know. N is equal to 7, yes. N is equal to 8, we don't know. N is equal to 9, we don't know. Now, you can check that in this case of 6, actually, when you make the table, in the integer modulo 6, right? The table will be, you know, there will be elements like 2 into 3 is equal to 0, right? So field has this property that if two numbers, the product of two numbers is equal to 0, this will imply that either A is equal to 0 or B is equal to 0. You are using this all the time, right? Product of two numbers is equal to 0. If this will imply this either A is equal to 0 or B is equal to 0. So this is not true in Z4. See, if you look at Z4, we have 2 into 2 is equal to 0, right? So none of them is 0. So that's why it is not a field. And Z6 is not a field because of the presence of 2 and 3. These are known as 0 divisors, okay? So that means this is also not a field. Okay, so Z6 is also not a field. Okay, so in fact, Zn is a field if and only if n is what? Any guess?
Prime number.
Very good. So if it is a prime number, we know that it is a field. So the question is, yes, please ask a question. Yeah.
Sir, why Z1 is not a field?
Because in any field, we require at least additive identity and multiplicative identity. So 0 and 1 must be there. So at least two number of elements are required. With one number of element, we will have only one identity, right? Because field means we want to play with all the four operations, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, right?
But Z1 will have an element 0 and 0 into 0 is 0. So the multiplicative identity of 0 is 0 itself.
No, it's so basically identity is one only. There is only, see, multiplicative identity is one only. One is a number which you multiply to every element will give you that number itself, right? That is a multiplicative identity.
Yes.
And additive identity is a different definition, right? So these are the two different things.
Sir, but okay. In case of zero, if we multiply zero by zero, then we will get that number itself zero.
Yeah, but that is fine. It's a very trivial case actually, you know, because what happens? You require both the two identities because that is the smallest requirement. Okay, because if you are trying to build a system, right, it should be smooth for all, right? The definition should be smooth.
Right? Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, yes, now the question is, what to do with this case, n is equal to 4? So, question is, how do we construct a field at all? So, this is a very interesting case. And I think now, be careful. I am going to shake your brain, okay, with bizarre things now. And whatever mathematics you have studied till now, you will see that things are a bit different here, okay? So let me actually show you some beautiful thing. It's a very beautiful thing. So what I do, you know, in order to construct a field with four number of elements, I go into our basics. You remember real numbers we have constructed complex numbers, right? And how we have done, we looked at equations of the form x squared plus 1 is equal to 0, right? This equation has no root, right, in reals, right? And suppose its root is I and I attach it to reals, and then we get complex numbers, which is a plus ib such that a and b are reals and I is the root of the equation. So I square plus 1 is equal to 0. I is the root of this equation. That means I is of the form square root of minus 1. Got it? You remember this this way of constructing complex numbers? So I'm going to use the same method and I'm going to look at, so what I'm going to do here now, I'm going to look at integer modulo 2, which has only two elements, 0 and 1, fine, which we saw that this is a field. And then I will try to look at a degree 2 polynomial, ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, right? And try to construct a field with, I denote it by GF4. It is known as Galois field. Okay. It stands for GF, means Galois field with four number of elements, right? So I'm going to use some sort of polynomial. Which polynomial I will use, it is not clear. So let us see immediately which polynomial is going to work. In our case here, it was x squared plus 1 from real to complex. From Z2 we filled with four number of elements. What kind of polynomial will work? That we need to check. So let us do this calculation. So we are with Z2 as 0, 1, fine, right? So let us look at this equation, ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a is not equal to 0, and a, b, c are the coefficients in Z2. Now remember, this is a different, so you might have studied Sridharachar formula, right? How will you solve it here? It is not clear because it's all different thing. So anyway, so I'm going to do one by one. I will make cases here because you see a is possibility for a, b, c are either 0 or 1. So b2 is 0 or 1, right? So either a is 0 or 1. Since a is not equal to 0, we know that a will be 1. So that means our equation is nothing but x square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, correct? Because a is not equal to 0, so a has to be 1. So now there are four possible. B has two choices, 0 and 1, and C has two choices, 0 and 1. That means there are four choices, four equations are possible. I'm writing all of them. One will be x square plus x plus 1 is equal to 0. Another one will be x square plus x is equal to 0. Another one will be x square plus 1 is equal to 0. Another one will be x square is equal to 0. All four possibilities. So B is either 0 or 1, and C is either 0 or 1. Okay, so I have filled in all the values, so I get four equations. Now my job is, if you compare here, this equation was having no root over reals, right? And we have taken that equation which is irreducible, which has no root over the reals. So we are going to look at all these four equations, which equation has no root on the Z2. In case of reals, we have Z2. So can you tell me whether x square equal to 0 has a root in Z2?
Yes.
The root x is equal to 0, right? So this equation is not going to work for us. Fine. What about this equation, x square plus 1 is equal to 0?
Yes,
will there be a root?
Yes, sir.
X is equal to 1 is a root, so this is also not going to work. What about this equation?
It has
a root x equal to 0, right? So yes, this is also not going to work. Now what about this equation? If I place x equal to 0 here, so 0 plus 0 plus 1, so 1, 0 is not a root. If I place x equal to 1 here, so 1 plus 1 is 0 plus 1. Again, 1 is not a root. So this means 0 and 1 are not the roots of this equation. So this equation is going to work for us. This is the equation which has no root over Z2. So x square plus x plus 1 is equal to 0 has no root in Z2. Fine. So this is the equation we are going to take. So remember, in the real and complex, I have taken, suppose I is the root of this equation, which is outside reals. I is a root which is outside reals, which is the complex number. In the same fashion, we can say that suppose alpha is a root of this equation, that means alpha square plus alpha plus 1 is equal to 0, where alpha does not belong to Z2. Right, alpha is not on the in Z2, but alpha is a root outside Z2. Okay, got it. Now I can construct the field, our field with four number of elements, or I can call it as, yes, any question?
This x square plus 1 is equal to 0, why it does not
work? X square plus 1 is equal to 0 because x is equal to 1 is a root here. 1 plus 1 is 0, modulo 2, right?
Sorry.
Yeah. Sir, why we took only polynomial of degree 2? Can't we take ax plus b or x cube polynomial?
Very good question. And actually, it turns out that, so right now I am trying to do the analogy with the reals to complex, right? I am just going one step further. If you take higher degree polynomial, we will get a field with more number of elements. So it will be clear to you in a minute, actually, when we do the calculations, okay? So when we do the calculations for degree 2 polynomial, I will do calculations for degree 3 polynomial as well in front of you. Okay. So okay. C2 alpha is a plus alpha b, just like that in the real to complex. where a and b are z2 in z2, and with the condition that alpha square plus alpha plus 1 is equal to 0. Got it? Just like that, real to complex, right? Here, in the same way, I have defined field with four number of elements. Correct? Any question at this point? Just with analogy. There it was a plus ib. Now I am writing a plus alpha b, where a and b are in z2, and alpha square plus alpha plus 1 is equal to 0. In place of I square plus 1 is equal to 0, we have alpha square plus alpha plus 1 is equal to 0. Now, so that means I can write it down, the values. So a and b are in z2 means two choices for a, two choices for b. So this will be 0, 1, 1 plus alpha and alpha, right? All these elements are there when we vary. Got it? So these are the basically four elements of the field with four number of elements. I can do some simplifications here. Note that alpha square plus alpha plus 1 is equal to 0. This means alpha square is equal to what? Minus alpha plus 1, correct?
Yes, now, sir.
Now, minus is same thing as plus 1 because 1 plus 1 is equal to 0. So 1 is equal to minus 1. So this is nothing but alpha plus 1. So alpha square is equal to alpha plus 1. So this quantity here is nothing but alpha square. So we can write down everything in the power of alpha. 0, 1, alpha, alpha square. Everything we can write down in the power of alpha. Also, we can write down in the polynomial in alpha. There are two representations for this. Another interesting note. Yes.
Can you repeat that? That 0, 1, 1 plus alpha and alpha.
Yeah, so 0, 1, 1 plus alpha, alpha we are getting from here, right? By choosing A and B. A is either 0 or 1, right? And B is either 0 or 1. We are getting all these four elements.
Yes.
Now I am saying that from here, alpha square is equal to minus alpha plus 1 from this equation, right?
Yes, yes. Okay. Yeah.
And minus 1 is same thing as plus 1 because 1 plus 1 is equal to 0. It's modulo 2. So minus alpha plus 1 is same thing as alpha plus 1, right? So
yes, okay.
1 plus alpha is same thing as alpha square. So the whole thing is nothing but can also be written as 0 plus 0, 1 alpha, alpha square, right?
Sir, what was GF4 you wrote?
GF4 is a name of the person who invented this. His name is Ivaris Galois. Okay, so Galois field, we call it Galois field. Okay,
yes,
Galois field 4. Galois field with four number of elements. Ivaris Galois is such an interesting person. He wrote all these discoveries before his death, and I think his age was around 17 or 18, just like your age, when he did all these discoveries and actually wrote a letter, and the next day he died in a battle, I think for a girl actually, he was in love with a girl and then there was a battle. So before actually doing this fighting, so he wrote all these things to one of his friend who later published it, So it's a very interesting story, Ivaris Galois, you can read more about it, So he invented these Galois fields, that's why the name of these objects are Galois field GF4, okay. Now, interesting thing to note here, what is the value of alpha cube? Can anyone tell me? So I think I can write it down here maybe. Alpha cube is what?
One.
Very good. Because alpha cube is equal to alpha into alpha square, right? Which is same thing as alpha times. Alpha square is same thing as 1 plus alpha, remember? So this is 1 plus alpha, right? Which is nothing but alpha plus alpha square. Now alpha plus alpha square from here is alpha plus alpha square is equal to minus 1, which is same thing as plus 1. Alpha square plus alpha is equal to minus 1, same thing as plus 1. So this whole thing is equal to 1. So alpha cube is equal to 1. This is a beautiful result. Right? Now
so, sir, that means alpha and alpha square are omega and omega square, right?
Yeah, so this is a very nice question you asked, and I was about to clear this doubt. So you think that this is just like a cube root of unity, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, but this is not. So what is happening here? You see, the equation is same. There it is omega square plus omega plus omega 1 is omega square plus omega plus 1 is equal to 0, right? and omega cube is equal to 1. Omega is a complex root of unity, right?
Yes, sir.
There is a difference here. Remember, there in omega square plus omega plus 1 is equal to 0, you can solve omega in terms of complex numbers, right?
Yes, sir.
But here there are no complex numbers. This is a discrete field. Okay. Z2 has only 2 elements, GF4 has only 4 elements. So many times people confuse it with the complex cube root of unity, but this is not the case. This is a different thing altogether.
So, sir, how can we visualize numbers alpha and alpha square?
Yeah, there are different ways visualizing these numbers. I will show you that in a minute, right? Okay. So, first, let us do one thing. First of all, I would like to make sure that you are convinced that this is a field with 4 number of elements. Okay. First, let us do that calculation. Okay. And then I will show you. Yes.
Sir, I am having a doubt. Sir, but my 1 is equals to minus 1. This result is true only when we are dealing with field, binary fields, right, sir?
Z2. So Z2 has this property that 1 plus 1 is equal to 0. So 1 is equal to minus 1.
Sir, right? But we are dealing with GF4, no, right, sir? Yeah.
Correct. So basically, in mathematical term, we call it the characteristic of the field GF4 is 2. That means if you take any element of GF4, add it twice, we'll get 0. Because 2 plus 1 is that characteristic, that flavor is coming from Z2 itself. Okay. So more precisely, we call it as the characteristic of the field is 2. That means A plus A is equal to 0 in this field. So A is equal to minus A. Okay.
Okay, means yeah, 1 is equal to minus 1 is true here because it is true in that GF4, right? Not in Z2.
Yeah. But actually, it is the flavor is coming from there. That flavor is coming from Z2 itself, actually, right?
Yes, in a way.
Okay. Now let us make the tables. You know, addition and multiplication table. Let us make a table here. So we have GF4 is equal to, we have element 0, 1, alpha, alpha square. Remember, alpha cube is equal to 1. We just saw alpha square plus alpha plus 1 is equal to 0. We saw alpha is equal square is equal to alpha plus 1. These calculations we know, right? Now, so basically, let us make the table. Addition table, 0, 1, alpha, alpha square, then 0, 1, alpha, alpha square. So 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 0 plus alpha is alpha, 0 plus alpha square is alpha square, 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, which is 0, 1 plus alpha is, 1 plus alpha is alpha square, so that's alpha square. And 1 plus alpha square is alpha. Correct. Alpha plus 0 is alpha. Alpha square. Alpha plus 1 is alpha square. Alpha plus alpha is 2 alpha, which is 0. And alpha plus alpha square is 1. Alpha square plus 0 is alpha square. Alpha square plus 1 is alpha. Alpha square plus alpha is 1. We are just playing with this equation, nothing more than that. And alpha square plus alpha square is 2 alpha square, which is 0. Then we make another table here. Multiplication, 0, 1, alpha, alpha square. 0, 1, alpha, alpha square. So we have 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. 1, alpha, alpha square. When you multiply with alpha into 1 is alpha. Alpha into alpha is alpha square. Alpha into alpha cube is 1. Alpha square into alpha 1 is alpha square. Alpha square into alpha is alpha cube, which is 1. Alpha raised to power 4 is how much?
Alpha.
That's very good. Good. So now I can make the additive int. I will encircle additive int in front of you. So now you can see that 0 plus 0 is 0. So 0 is inverse of itself.
Sir, in this way, we didn't took the module of 4.
modulo 4 is a different thing. Remember, we are not doing with modulo 4. That is not a field. You saw that. If you look at here, modulo 4 is not a field because 2 into 2 is equal to 0.
So we are finding an alternate way, right?
Yeah. So modulo arithmetic fails here. So it's a slightly different thing.
Okay. Good.
Yes. So 0 plus 0 is 1 plus 1 is 0. So 1 is self-invertive. Alpha plus alpha is 0. So alpha is self-invertive. And alpha square plus alpha square is equal to 0. So alpha square is self-invertive. Every element is self-invertive. Fine. So this is true. What about multiplication? I encircle multiplicative int is here. And now 1 into 1 is 1. Fine. Then alpha into alpha square is equal to 1. So alpha and alpha inverses are inverses of each other, alpha square and alpha. Okay. So that is one thing. So that means every non-zero element has its inverse. Inverse of alpha is alpha square, you know. And so this is a field. Right. So this is a field.
Hello, sir, I have a doubt.
Yes, Pucho.
Sir, the thing is 1 plus 1 is equals to 0. We took from Z2 field, right?
Correct, correct. The flavor is there,
so,
from there.
Sir,
yeah.
Can we say that alpha plus alpha, 2 alpha modulo 2 is also equal to 0?
Actually, because you see, the coefficient of these elements here is coming from the ground field Z2 itself. That's why this flavor is here. And because in Z2, 1 plus 1 is 0, right? That yes. is why this flavor is coming on ZF4.
Sir, in Z2, we did think that is 1 plus 1 is 2, modulo 2 of 2 is 0.
Zero. So that means Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. That is the same thing as 1 is equal to minus 1. So once we got that flavor from there, that 1 is equal to minus 1, I can use the same thing here. That's
all. Yeah, sir. So can we apply this to alpha, like alpha plus alpha, 2 alpha, modulo 2 is 0, means 2 alpha
yes,
is
yes.
1 number.
Yes, yes, because of that, correct. It is because of that only, yes. So essentially it is saying that the characteristic of the field is 2. That if you take any element, if you add it, it will be 0 here. Okay. Now, one thing I want to tell you now, a very important thing, that here the elements, this is known as power representation, what I have shown to you, known as power representation. Means everything is in the power of alpha. Okay. Another representation I can do is the following. I write it down as 0, 1, alpha, and alpha square is 1 plus alpha, remember? Fine. So this is known as polynomial representation, polynomial in alpha representation, okay? This is known as polynomial representation like this. This is known as power representation, power of alpha, right? I can also write down everything in the form of bits. How? Because you remember, we have A plus alpha B, where A and B are in Z2, and that's why we got these things, right? So when both A and B are 0, 0, we are getting 0, 0, right? 1 will correspond to what value of A and what value of B? A is 1 and B is 1, 0. Very good. And what about alpha?
0, 1.
And what about 1 plus alpha?
1, 1.
So we are getting binary strings of length 2. They also represents the field. Got it? So this is known as binary representation. So basically,
could you please repeat binary?
Yeah, so I am saying that every element here, 0, 1, alpha, 1 plus alpha is coming from A plus alpha B, where A is 0 or 1, B is 0 or 1, right? So I'm just substituting 0 is corresponds to 0, 0. When A is 0, B is 0, I will get 0. So I am writing 0, 0. When A is 1, B is 0, I will get 1, 0. Right? When A is 1, B is 0, I will get alpha, so which is this. I'm just writing the values of A and B here. That's all. And both are 1, we will get 1, 1. right?
Hello, sir.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Yes.
Sir, can you please repeat why alpha plus alpha is equal to 0?
Yeah, because it is 2 alpha. See, because I would say that modulo 2, everything is 0, right? Because everything, that favor is coming from Z2. Z2, what is happening? Modulo 2, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So this is
sir, sir, alpha is not, alpha is not 0 and alpha is not 1. So how can alpha plus alpha will be equal to 0?
Correct. Very beautiful question. The question is that I am not worrying about alpha. I am worrying about the coefficient. Okay. The coefficient of alpha is what? Alpha plus alpha, the coefficient is 2 alpha, right?
Yes.
Alpha plus alpha is 2 alpha and coefficient is 0 mod 2.
Okay. Okay, sir.
Yeah, yes. Coefficient. We are worrying about the coefficient because coefficients are coming from the ground thing, ground field. Okay. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this was the field with two number of elements, four number of elements, right? So you remember, if you look at here, so we are able to do field with four numbers. So two is Z2, three is Z3, four I have shown you, now it is GF4. 5 is Z5, fine. Z6 is not a field, right? 7 is a field, integer modulo 7, because n is a prime, it will be field. What about 8? The question is 8, we don't know, right? So any idea, 8, can we, will be able to construct a field? The answer is yes. And let me show you quickly how this can be done. Okay?
Please repeat the reason why Z6 is not a field.
Z6 is not a field because of presence of zero divisors. 2 into 3 is equal to 0. Field, every field has this property. The product of two numbers equal to 0 means every, you know, one of them has to be 0. In other words, we are saying that every element in a field, every element should have inverse. Here, 2 does not have an inverse.
Okay.
So, sir, we found GF4, so similarly, can we not find GF6?
Yeah, people tried and they were unsuccessful. Okay. So, now we know that actually there is no field of order 6. Okay, we cannot construct. Okay, there is a proof also. Oh, yeah. Okay, got it. So, you will see that the structure of these fields are, you know, really beautiful. So, don't you think it's a beautiful thing, right? It's a field with four number of elements. Why these things are important? Why I am teaching these things? So basically, you can see here, these are two bits, right? Right? Every element in this field is two bits, right? Have you heard of byte? The term byte?
Yes, sir.
Byte means sir. How many bits?
Eight bits.
And 8 bits mean which field? How many elements? 256, right?
Yes, sir.
So byte, that's why everything in computer is in terms of bytes, because we play with fields with 256 number of elements. Okay. So your packets are nothing but elements of these finite fields. Whatever computer packets you handle. That's why this is a very important thing. Okay. Got it? So these are 2 bits. 8 bits is 256. Now I'm going to show you 3 bits.
And sir, why didn't we take a polynomial of degree 3 instead of degree 2?
And that's what I'm going to take now, and you will see the reason. Okay.
Okay, sir.
We are coming here now. Now, I want to construct field with 2 cube. So we saw that field with 2 square number of elements, right? So actually this power 2 has something to do with the degree of the polynomial that we take. In GF4, this 2 is an important thing. That's why we have taken degree 2 polynomial. Now here it is degree 3 we need to take, GF3. It's 8, GF8, right? Filled with 8 number of elements. Okay. So now I look at degree 3 polynomial. This will be AX cube plus BX square plus CX plus D is equal to 0. Where A is not equal to 0 and A, B, C and D belongs to Z2, right? Z2 is filled with 2 number of elements. Got it? So how many polynomials will be there? Can anyone answer? How many such polynomials will be there? A is not equal to 0, so obviously
8.
Okay, very good. So since A is not equal to 0, A is equal to 1, we are left with this. So I'm writing all of the polynomials. One of them will be x cube plus x square plus 1 is equal to 0. Another one will be x cube plus x plus 1 is equal to 0. Another one will be x cube plus x is equal to 0. Another one will be x cube plus x square is equal to 0. Another one will be x cube plus 1 is equal to 0. Another one will be x cube is equal to 0. And x cube plus x square plus x is equal to 0. Now, can this polynomial work? Is it irreducible polynomial? Is there any root of this polynomial Z2? We start one by one.
Zero.
So this is not going to work, right? Because x equal to 0 is a root here.
Sir,
right?
One big polynomial is x cube plus x square plus x plus 1 is not.
Huh? 3, 4, 5, 6. No, I have taken all
b
8
equals
polynomial.
To 1 is left.
Hmm?
All B, C, and D all are 1.
B, C, D equal to 1.
B, C, and D all are 1. These are only 7.
Means x cube plus x square plus x plus 1 polynomial is not taken.
X cube plus?
X square x plus x plus 1.
B, C, D 1, all 3 1.
No, but I have already 8. If 8 polynomials are there, how can be there more? You see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 7.
We have taken.
Okay. Yeah, x cube plus?
X square plus x plus 1.
Very good. Fine. So what about this polynomial? Is this going to have a root in Z2? Yes, x equal to 1 will be a root, right?
X equals to 1.
Yeah, so this is not going to work. What about this? It is going to work? No?
No, sir.
X equal to 0 is a root. This polynomial is going to work? No?
No, sir. X equal to 1.
X equal to 1 is a root. Because x equal to 1 is a root. Here, x equal to 0 is a root. What about this polynomial? This is going to work? No, because 0 is a root. This is also not going to work because x equal to 0 is a root. What about this polynomial? If x equal to 0 or x equal to 1?
It is a root. No,
it is work.
This is working. What about x cube plus x square plus 1 is equal to 0? X equal to plus x. X equal to 0. And x equal to 1 is not a root. So this is also going to work. Ab kya kare? Ab to 2 aa gaye. Any idea? Ab kya hoga?
2 roots, alpha and beta.
Nahin, 2 roots to theek hai. दो पॉलिनोमियल्स आ गए ना, व्हाट वी विल डू नाउ?
इट कैन हैपन दैट x इक्वल्स टू x
स्क्वायर, कॉमन रूट ले लेंगे.
नहीं, देयर इज अ ब्यूटीफुल थिंग. अभी अगर क्लास में आधे लोग x³ + x² + 1 = 0 ले और क्लास में आधे लोग x³ + x + 1 = 0 पॉलिनोमियल ले, दोनों से अलग-अलग चीजें बनाने की कोशिश करें, एक्चुअली दोनों इक्विवेलेंट आ जाती हैं. दैट इज अ ब्यूटीफुल थिंग. That is the beauty of mathematics, right? You start with different polynomials. So, agar abhi main class mein maan lo ek polynomial leke karta hu kaam, x cube plus x plus 1 is equal to 0 leke karunga, to kuch log ghar mein jaake x cube plus x square plus 1 is equal to 0 lekar ke bhi construct kare and see the relationship between the table that you construct here and the table that you construct there. Okay? So, they are the same. I mean, they will give you equivalent fields. You know, so let me take this field. Galois field with 8 number of elements will be A plus alpha B plus alpha square C. Now, such that A, B, C belongs to Z2. Right? And of course, alpha satisfies the equation alpha cube plus alpha plus 1 is equal to 0. I am taking the polynomial x cube plus x plus 1 is equal to 0. Right? So, I can write down the elements of the field 0, 1, alpha, alpha square, alpha cube, alpha raised to power 4, alpha raised to power 5, alpha raised to power 6. Of course, I have not meshed with these polynomials, so I can just mesh that for you. Alpha cube is nothing but alpha plus 1, right? From here, because alpha cube is equal to alpha plus 1. Right. What about alpha raised to the power 4?
Alpha square plus alpha.
Is alpha square plus alpha, because we multiplied with this. Fine. Alpha raised to the power 5 will be alpha cube plus alpha square, which is same thing as 1 plus alpha. Plus alpha square, right? And alpha raised to the power 6 is equal to alpha plus alpha square plus alpha cube is same thing as alpha plus alpha square plus alpha plus 1 is equal to alpha square plus 1. Very good. What about alpha raised to the power 7 now? So we have got alpha raised to the power 4 is equal to alpha square plus alpha. Alpha raised to the power 5 is equal to 1 plus alpha square. And alpha raised to the power 6 is equal to alpha square plus 1, right? All the elements now we also represented as a polynomial representation, right? What about alpha raised to the power 7? Is alpha square plus 1, right? Alpha raised to the power 6, the value humne substitute kar di, which is same thing as alpha cube plus alpha.
1.
Which is alpha cube is equal to alpha plus 1 plus alpha is equal to 1. Because 2 alpha is equal to 0. So alpha raised to power 7 is equal to 1. That's a beautiful thing. So yahan pe jitni powers aa rahi hain, uske next power will give you 1, right? This is how we construct field with 8 number of elements. So remember, I have taken the polynomial x cube plus x plus 1 is equal to 0 to construct this. You can use the other polynomial, this polynomial x cube plus x square plus 1 is equal to 0, and you will see that you will get similar things there. Okay. Got it? So
yes, sir.
This is the construction, the basic construction of field with 8 number of elements. In fact, yes, any question? Yeah.
No.
Okay. Now I would like to mention something very beautiful here. So the ground field we constructed is our Z2. From GF2, we can construct field with 4 number of elements. You saw a higher order field is field with 8 number of elements. So field with 8 number of elements can be constructed from GF4 as well directly, you know, by taking a degree 2 polynomial. Or if you take degree 3 polynomial, we can go from here to here. Then this goes to GF2 raised to 4, 16, and so on. You come up to Galois field with 2 raised for m number of elements. Okay. One question that I would like to ask you. So this is a field with 2 raised for m elements. Okay. Similarly, if you take ZP, integer modulo P, if P is a prime number. Okay, so then GP is our field with Galois field with P number of elements. I can construct Galois field with P square number of elements. I can construct Galois field with PQ number of elements, and so on. Finally, I can construct Galois field with P raised for M number of elements. So that means a field with Q number of elements exists if and only if Q is a prime power. It is clear from here. Got it? So this is how the construction will go. Of course, this is not a formal proof, but I am just giving you an idea why a field with Q number of elements exists if and only if Q is a prime power. In that case, if we come back to our construction methods in this table here, you see. So here, you know, field with 9 number of elements will exist because this is 3 square, right? With 10, it will not exist. With 11, yes, it will exist. With 12, it will not exist. 13, yes, it will exist. Right? So you know when it will exist. 8 is 2 cubed, so that's why there is a field with that number of elements. 4 is 2 squared, that's why there is a field with 2 squared number of elements. Any question at this point?
Sir, down.
Yeah,
sir, you told we can go from GF of 8 to 4. How can we do that?
Yeah, so again, there the construction will be your a plus alpha b, where alpha is a root of a polynomial over GF4 of degree 2, which is irreducible. The polynomial should be irreducible over GF4. Okay, so that is the how you can go.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, why don't the GF8 those inverse have 4 to the 8 like GF6?
Pardon? What is the question? I don't understand. Yeah.
Sir, GF8 don't have those inverse 4 to the 8.
Yeah. So you can now make the table actually. So I leave it as an exercise for you to make these tables, you know.
GF8. Sir, then also why it is possible? Like it is contradicting.
What is contradicting?
That it has those inverse, then also it is the field is possible.
Oh, it has what inverse? I don't understand your question actually. What inverse?
Like in 6, 2 into 3.
Yes,
it is 0. Yeah. So, in 6, there are 0 devices. But in GF8, there is no such 0 device.
In GF8.
Huh?
If we construct the table, it has 4 to the 8, sir.
No, 4 to the 8. No, what are you saying? But I am not doing it with modulo. I am not dealing with modulo. You see?
Why?
Yeah, so I'm, see, basically Z4, there was a problem, right?
Yes.
There was a problem. We cannot construct a field. That's why we are going in this method. This is an alternative method. So the problem started with G4. So here there is a problem. That's why we did not do this. Similarly, Z8, if you do, this is not going to work. This is not a field.
Ah, okay, sir. Got it.
Yeah. Got it. Any more questions? So I think I would invite you to make a table for GF8, you know. So write down the elements, you know, 0, 1, alpha, alpha square, alpha cube, alpha raised to power 4, alpha raised to power 5, alpha raised to power 6. Addition ki table bana lo, multiplication ki table bana lo, right? And just make sure that every element has a inverse with respect to addition and multiplication. Got it? So I hope you will be able to complete. So some exercise, actually T problem. Normally I give T problem. So in the evening, first T problem is make tables for addition and multiplication for GF8. Right? Got it? Okay. And second T time problem, you know, in the evening when at 4 o'clock you will take T. You can do these problems, you know. Second, take the polynomial x cube plus x square plus 1 is equal to 0 and try to make tables. Third, see the relationship. Between field coming from this and field coming from x cube plus x plus 1 is equal to 0. We have shown you the calculation for this. You can do the calculation for this at home and see what is the connection between these two. Okay. So 3T type problems. Actually, one more thing I should mention here. So as I told you, your bytes are nothing but filled with 2 raised to power 8 number of elements. Right, which is filled with 256 number of elements. All your bytes coming from here. This field, okay, that is filled with 256 number of elements. Also 256 is important because all the ASCII characters are 256 only, right? So this is the thing, and I guess yeah, so finally I think in the exercise you will see that we are asking you to construct field with 2 raised to power 4, 16 number of elements, and do the same calculations and do some calculations. So I think, for example, I may ask you here, say in, so here also in GF8, this is a power alpha representation, right? And this is a polynomial representation. You can also have a representation like 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, right? This is the bits representation, right? When we have A, B, C, we need to vary. Two choices here, two choices here, two choices here. We'll give you all these 8, Okay. So what I'm saying that this is another representation of the fields. Now, if I ask you, what is the value of square root of 111? Can you find out? So you need to find out what is the value of 111. 111 turns out to be
110
is alpha raised to power 5, right? 111 turns out to be alpha raised to power 5, correct?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Because this is 111, if you see, this is alpha raised to power 5, right? And so when 111 square root is there, this will be 5 by 2. Now we know that alpha raised to power 7 is equal to 1. How much power of alpha I should multiply? I should get proper answer here, right? So I need to multiply with some power of alpha as much as I can, because this can be written as I can multiply with 7. 7 I can add, and then so basically you can compute what is the power, what is the square root, right? I leave it to you. This is also an exercise. If you are not able to get it, we will look at the I will answer you on WhatsApp. By the way, I can also answer what is the value of 101 divided by 011. So 101 is what? 101 is 1 plus alpha square, right? Which is alpha raised to power 6 divided by 011. 011 is alpha plus alpha square, which is alpha raised to power 4. So this is alpha square, right? Alpha square is?
Yes.
So alpha square is what?
001.
Na?
Yeah.
001. Right. So these calculations you can do in the arithmetic, right? Okay. So basically you can do addition, subtraction, multiplication, division with these bits. And that is how we implement, actually, Okay. So this is a very important topic, modular arithmetic and finite field. In the next class, yes.
Sir, in a finite GF9, we have 0, 1, 0, 2, 1, 2, like that, right?
Yeah, so I think GF9, if you want, I can briefly look at this. GF9, if I want to construct, this is GF3 square, right? So our ground field will be 0, Z3, which is 0, 1, 2, okay? And now I look at it, because this is 3 square, so I look at a degree 2 polynomial. So ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, such that a is not equal to 0, and a, b, c belongs to Z3. Okay? So you look at all the polynomials and look at the one which is irreducible, which has no root over Z3, and that will be used to construct field with 9 number of elements. It's a good exercise. आज की चाय के साथ कल की चाय का इंतजाम भी हो गया, राइट? सो ट्राई दिस.
एंड सर, यू टोल्ड टू टेल हाउ विजुलाइज दिस अल्फा एंड अल्फा स्क्वायर इन GF4.
या सो बेसिकली दे यू कैन विजुलाइज देम एज 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 दीज थिंग्स, एज दीज बिट्स, ओके, ऑल दीज एलिमेंट्स रादर देन अल्फा यू कैन यूज लाइक दिस, नो प्रॉब्लम, राइट?
Okay.
Alpha is the form of symbols, and here
Is there any other way to visualize?
There are only three ways. One is this representation, one is power of alpha representation, and one is polynomial representation, which is here. That's all. There are three ways only.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
One interesting thing is there, basically in this finite field business, your line has only 2 points. If you look at the geometrical meaning, line has only 2 points, So rather than R square, you have the space, So here we have R square or R cube. Here the space is Z2 square or Z2 cube. So cube has only 8 points here, and plane has only 4 points here. That's all. A line has Z2. 2 points only. Okay. Here there are infinitely many. So it's a really interesting thing. I will sometime, in the class, today is very beginning lecture, but later on I will tell you how to visualize subspaces, etc. in these spaces. It's really interesting and a little bit non-trivial. So whatever mathematics you have been looking at till now will not be there. Okay. So I hope you have got tea time problems. Please make sure that while drinking tea, you solve these problems. Your assignment will be up pretty soon. So you can start doing the assignments as well. Okay. So I think that's all for today. If you have any questions, you can ask me on WhatsApp as well. Okay. Thank you. And lecture will be available, on your YouTube. Okay.
Hello, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, good. Thank you.
Sir, I have one doubt.
Yeah, pucho.
Sir, from GF 2 to GF 4, we consider a polynomial of degree 2. Yes. Why can't we consider a polynomial of degree 3?
If we'll consider polynomial degree 3, we'll get filled with 8 number of elements. That is how the construction is.
Sorry, sir, I didn't understand. More number of elements.
Yeah, then you will get more number of elements then, because degree 3 polynomial, as I told you, if I want to construct a field with the, say, 16 number of elements, so 16 is 2 raised to the power 4. So I have to construct, I have to look at degree 4 polynomial in the ground field. So that degree is determined from power, what you want to construct. That is how the construction is right now. I think, of course, there is a lot more theory, but I think at your stage, I mean, it's enough for you to know that how to construct it. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you.